Bangkok is home to over 9 million people. This hot concrete jungle is one of the most polluted cities in Asia, but the rooftop of one of its skyscrapers hosts an innovative urban farm. Set up by local company Nergaya, it produces spirulina, an edible algae that is a sustainable source of protein, even an alternative to meat.
Spirulina is a single cell microorganism, and as a microalgae, it has a very high concentration of specific nutrients, which kind of get it the classification of a superfood. It tends to be between 60 and 70% protein by dry weight, and it also has a very strong profile of other vitamins and minerals, very high in antioxidants, omega-3 and omega-5 fatty acids, and the protein is also a complete protein. It has all 8 essential amino acids, which most plant-based proteins do not.
Armed with spirulina, Nergaya hopes to tackle the nutritional and environmental problems of today. Their system allows fresh food to be produced in urban areas, and spirulina consumes CO2 through photosynthesis. At the Nergaya laboratories, the team breeds algae, studies different strains, and works on the rooftop facility. Their bioreactors form a closed system, reducing the risk of contamination and producing 1 kg of spirulina from 15 liters of water, the majority of which is reused.
We use air pressures to move water from a tank to another tank and give oxygen and agitation and mixing. So at the moment we have 80 bioreactors run an operation at Novotel and can produce around 60 to 80 kilograms per month of fresh paste spirulina. After I do harvest at Novotel, I take it back to the office here, and then we do rinsing, processing, dewatering, and packing.
Spirulina is harvested 3 times a week and distributed to 6 retailers in Bangkok. One of them is Novotel itself, that also integrated spirulina into its menu. Fresh spirulina tastes a little like spinach and can be mixed with other food and drinks.
At the moment, we sell at around $85 per kilo. But again, it's still very expensive to most of people. Because right now, we're still small. When we have a big facility, I believe we can make the price a lot cheaper. The company goal is we try to make it available to the mainstream market, even poor people. So it can be in India or in Burma, in Thailand, around Southeast Asia.
In other countries, in places where they don't have fertile soil, places that are more arid, it becomes a very viable option in order to produce a high protein food source locally.
It can be grown everywhere as long as you have light and a bit of water. So I wish today's world leaders or big companies would be attracted and start to continue what Nergaya have started here